A groundbreaking discovery from a University of Hawaii at Manoa researcher is making waves in the science community. It's a discovery that could help rewrite the story of human evolution. Jill Kuramoto has more.
UH Manoa anthropology professor Christopher Bay likens his discovery to piecing together a giant puzzle, but with fossils.
Like a part of a mandible like this, right? And then you have to figure out, what do you have? What is it, right?
After more than 30 years of studying ancient human ancestors in Asia, Bay believes he's discovered a missing piece, and the moment of realization was the highlight of his career.
And then we said, you know what? This actually doesn't look anything like Homo sapiens, and it doesn't look anything like these other fossils, right? So that's when we started to think that we are onto something.
The new species is called Homo juluensis and lived in Eastern Asia around 50,000 years ago. A notable characteristic is their rather large heads.
So if this is 1,000 and this is 1,300, suddenly you've got something like much, much larger, right? So it's one of the distinguishing characteristics of this new species, Homo juluensis. It's pretty interesting because it has an average cranial capacity between 1,700 and 1,800.
The study is significant because it adds to our understanding of human evolution and helps bridge gaps in fossil records of Asia, which is often overshadowed by discoveries in Africa and Europe.
A lot of the people working in Asia said, you know what, the fossils in China don't look anything like the European fossils. They don't look anything like the African fossils. But the Western paleanthropologists kept insisting that we're just going to group these guys into this name Heidelbergensis. And now it's becoming clear that the fossils in China should clearly have a different name.
Bay was adopted by an American family at 1.5 years old and says his lifelong search for his identity is likely what led him into paleoanthropology.
Because it's kind of reconstructing a puzzle without having all the pieces.
Professor Bay says the work is far from over. More research is needed to confirm how Homo juluensis fits into the human family tree. If he met him in person, Professor Bay says, he'd probably ask him one thing.
I would ask, are there more of you? and where can I find them?
Jill Kuramoto, K22 News, working for Hawaii.